Thank you for stopping by Ballistic Barbecue. Today, I am going to be copycatting the most expensive hamburger in the world, the Glamburger from the Honky Tonk in the UK. Let's get going. All right, now before we kick this recipe off, I want to give a little shout out to my buddy Gary House over at the Cooking Everything Outdoors channel. Now, Gary actually threw a little friendly challenge out at me to see if I could pull this recipe off. So thank you, Gary. And on that note, he's either the one to thank or the one to blame for what you're about to see here. Now, as I said, the Honky Tonk over in the UK is serving up this burger and they're selling it for 1,100 British pounds. That equates to about 1,700 plus US dollars. Crazy expensive. And I can guarantee I didn't pay that much to cook this up. I think I'm gonna come pretty darn close, but bear in mind, I'm using ingredients that I can source and I'm sure they're using the top of the line over there. Anyway, let's get going. We're gonna start off by making a mango champagne jus. This is gonna go as one of the toppings, one of the condiments on this burger. So, I have here one mango diced up, put it in my food processor. Now, in watching a video of the executive chef of the Honky Tonk cook this burger, it looks like he's adding some blood orange juice. So this is the juice from two pretty small blood oranges. So I'm gonna go ahead and blend this up, try to liquefy this mango as much as I can. All right, it's looking good. All right, what I have here is a glass bowl, wire strainer, and I am going to try to extract as much of the juice out of this as I can. All right, looks good. Let's move on to the next step. All right, I have my skillet going here. Put in about 3 tablespoons of butter. This is salted butter. We're going to add 2 tablespoons of minced shallot. I want to get these softened up. I have here 1 cup of champagne. We are going to be using more champagne in this. And that puree for the mango and the blood orange juice. Throw in 1 bay leaf, 1 piece of star anise. And I'm going to bring this up and then let it reduce. All right, this is looking good. I'm gonna go ahead and lower the flame. Get this star anise out of here, get that bay leaf out of here. I'm gonna add a little bit more butter. About 4 tablespoons more, get that stirred in. Looks good, let's give it a little taste. Add just a little bit of salt. A little bit of pepper. Okay, what I'm going to do now is set this off to the side, let it cool down. Once it's cooled, I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of champagne and we're going to get it back in the food processor. What I want to do is break down the shallot because again, we're putting this sauce on a hamburger and I want it to flow. Anyway, let's move on to the next component of this crazy hamburger. Okay, so the next component of this burger is going to be a matcha green tea mayo. I'm going simple on this. I really don't know how complicated they're going, but what I have here is some matcha green tea, green powdered tea. Not cheap. And I have some Japanese mayonnaise in here that I bought at my Japanese market. And I'm just gonna add a little bit until it looks about right. And I've been waiting for the opportunity to use this stupid little thing. Anyway, let's get this stirred up. And there we go, looks good. So this is about 1/2 cup of that mayo and about 1 teaspoon, maybe a little bit more than 1 teaspoon of the powdered green tea. All right, let's move on. All right, we're gonna go ahead and kick this burger up on the opulent scale a few notches. I have here some brie cheese. I've cut the rind off and I softened it just a little bit. Here I got miniature black truffle. I'm gonna go ahead and shave this in here a little bit. so. Get in there, trouble. All right, I'm going to go ahead and get this blended up into the cheese. There we go. Let's go ahead and make us a burger patty now. All right, so here's the meat I'm going to use. And basically what this is, it's 220 grams of American Wagyu beef. Now, the Honky Tonk's actually using Japanese Kobe beef. This is Kobe style American Wagyu. And it's 60 grams of venison blended up. And I guess they do that to kind of balance out the fat to meat ratio. Let's go ahead and divide this in half. You see how buttery this fat is? Personally, I'd go with, you know, just a regular, a good cut of meat, like a ribeye or something. This Wagyu fat is just so soft and buttery, it can actually cause problems sometimes. That's my opinion. All right, let's get some of this brie in the middle here. So basically what we're doing is making a fancy Juicy Lucy here. All right, we are done with the patty now. Let's move on to the next step. Again, it's gonna get wackier and wackier here. All right, the Honky Tonk uses brioche, which is cool. It's my favorite hamburger bun. What I've done here is coated the top with a really thin coating of clarified butter. And I have here 24 karat gold leaf, edible gold leaf. We're gonna coat this whole bun with this gold leaf. All right, and here we are, looking good. Can't say I've ever eaten a burger with a golden bun yet, but we'll go ahead and get this out of the way. And on for more gilding the lily, so to speak. So what I have here is a duck egg. It's been smoked. Now before I smoked it, I actually sous vide this thing. I sous vide it while in its shell, but I only sous vide it long enough to set the white so that the yolk is still more of a custardy kind of a consistency. That's why it's kind of got this bit of a deformed shape to it. So we're gonna go ahead and put some gold leaf on this too. And there we go, the golden egg. Believe it or not, I think we're actually at a point where we can go outside and start cooking, so meet you out in the backyard. All right, let's get this show on the road. First thing we're going to do is season this patty, and I have some smoked Himalayan sea salt. I smoked it along with the duck egg. A little bit more salt. All right, we got some good color coming up. We're going to go ahead and give this bad boy a flip. All right, we have no briquettes on this side, but I have a nice radiant heat. We're going to utilize that to get a nice toast on these buns. Nice toast. All right, looks like the patty's done. Let's go ahead and build us a Glamburger. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is lay down some of that matcha sauce. Then we're going to lay down some lettuce. This is just butter lettuce. And it looks like that's what they're using. Go ahead and get that gorgeous patty down. Some heirloom tomatoes. We're laying down some smoked bacon, and this has been coated with maple syrup. And this bacon was actually given to me by a subscriber, turn channel holder. His name is Eric. He has a channel called Opsic Barbecue, and this is from Benton's Farms or Benton's Smoked Meats, and it's killer, killer bacon. So bacon down. Now we're going to put some butter and saffron poached lobster down. Now I'm going to hit it with some of that mango jus. Now we're going to put down some caviar. This is from Siberia. Some decent caviar here. Now we're going to put down that smoked and gilded duck egg. Now at the actual restaurant, they grade on white truffle afterwards. All I have is a black, poor me. So I'm going to go ahead and grate on some black truffle. So we're going to go ahead and plate this with a bun at a slight tilt here, and then they put a little flag in. So guess what? There we go. The Glamburger. Are we ready to try it? Yes, we are. All right, let's get the ballistic barbecue flag out of here. Get that bun on. Now, one thing I know about eating this is I'm gonna get gold all over my face, so you'll get a little laugh out of that. Let's go ahead and cut this bad boy in half. Oh my gosh. It's definitely the richest burger I've ever had. It's good. It's good. Would I pay that much money for it? No. I think I probably hit the mark with a lot of the flavor combos I have here. That sauce, that mango sauce, is killer. It's just got the perfect amount of sweet and the nice savory notes to it. The lobster and the bacon and that Kobe beef, it's very, 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 very rich. Very rich. But I'm glad I did it. Thank you, Gary. Anyway, folks, thank you for stopping by. Again, please, if you want to see me try to do something crazy like this, or maybe not as crazy as this, give me a shout. Till my next video. Here, beer people, guess what this is. Anyway, cheers.